Hello guys, my name is Atuji. Welcome back to my channel LG3600. So in this video I'm going to show you how to list all the online users. So this will be the last video of this series. So if you want more videos like this, just click the subscribe button down below and click the notification bell. So without much further talk, let's get started. So the goal of this video is to get to create a red or green dot near the user's name so that we can identify whether user is online or not. So we can start by going to our chance.php inside our routes file, and we can create a new channel. So I will just copy the previous one and paste it down below, and I'm going to change the channel name to online. You can give any name if you want, and I'm going to remove all the other parameters and just getting the user, and I will just return user. So you may be thinking why I'm returning user instead of returning true or false, and this is because we are going to create a presence channel instead of the private channel. So you can know more about it in the Laravel documentation. I will give the link of the documentation in the description down below. So now we can go to our assets.js and app.js file, and inside here we can create a new variable, and I will create I will name the variable as online users, and by default I will leave it as blank. And now down below we can create a if condition to check whether the the user who is viewing the browser is logged in or not. We can do it by just checking whether the user ID is not equal to undefined. It's not undefined. We'll check whether the user ID is not equal to null. Since we are inside our views and layouts app.blade.php in the meta tag, where is it? Right here. We are first checking whether the user is authenticated or not, and then if is online authenticated, then we are echoing his ID or we are echoing null. So we need to check if it is null or not. So once we have found that the user ID is not equal to null, we can create a echo, and we are going to join the online channel. Okay, next is dot here. So when a user comes online, this here will be triggered, and we'll be having access to the online the user's details. So what we will do is this dot online users dot or equal to users. Yeah. So the next one will be joining. So this function will be triggered when a new user comes online. So user equals, and we will push the newly came user to the old array of the online users. So we can do it by online users. Online users dot push the user. Okay, now that's fine. And the next one is leaving. So when a user goes out of the logs out, we will have the access to the user who just gone out, and we will just remove the user from the array of the online users. So this dot online users equals this dot online users dot filter and a function. So u equals u not equals the user. So This is what this function is doing is that it it gives a value to this online users variable by filtering the user which just gone out. Okay, now that's it for the echo part. Now let's move on to the front end part. So now let's open up our chat index.blade.php, and we are going to wrap this friend name inside a div. So a div, and down below we are going to create a new component, and I will name it as chat or online user. Yeah, that's enough. And we will bind we bind friends. So I will pass in the friend from the friend detail from this loop. So friend echoing, I'm echoing the details of the friend. So the next will be we bind and all the online users equals online users. Okay, so I'll close the tag, and now we need to create this component. So for that, inside our components folder, I will create a new file. I will name it as online user dot view and click on enter. Create a basic template. So I will create a new div here, and I will give it a class of is pulled right. So this is a Bulma class, and inside this div we are going to create span. Yeah, span is enough. And I will give it a class of red. Oh wait a minute, we can give it a italics tag so that we can have access to the font asm. I will give the class as FA and FA circle. And red. So this will be displayed if the user is offline. So I will create one more dot here and change the class as green. Inside our style, I will give it a style. So red equals color. Red, you can give any color you want, I'm preferring red, and the green will be having a color of green. And inside our script we need to get all the details of the online users. So friend and online users. Now compile this and let's go to our browser and reload. Oopsie, I forgot to run PHP artisan serve. So I have also forgot to register the new component. So I'll just copy this line and paste it down below and change the component name as online user and the location to online user.view file. So, and I also found a minor mistake that we have done. I have added a semicolon out here, and just remove it if you have done. So if I reload now, I can see a red and a green dot. So now our goal is to show any one of the dot. If the user is online, then the green should be shown, or if the user is offline, then the red should be shown. So for that, let's go to our online user.view file and create a methods down here. So I will create a new method as check user. You can name anything you want. So function, and I will be returning something like a true or false or an array itself, so that if condition can automatically check whether the returning is empty or not. So it will if the return is empty, then it will trigger it as a false, and if there is something inside the return, then it will trigger it as true. So what we are going to do is that we are going to find whether this friend, which is passed in by passed by the our view file, and this is all the users who is logged in, and we are going to check whether that the friend is inside this online users. So if it he is inside this online users, then he is online. Then if he is not, then he is offline. So that's what we are going to do. So this friend is a this find is a lodash command. So we have access to lodash. So if you remove the lodash while you started this project from the package.json file, where it is here. So if you remove this line of code and rent npm install, then you don't have access to this command. So make sure that you have lodash installed. So find first parameter will be the online users. So this is and second will be id equals this dot friend dot id. Yeah, so what this doing is that it is checking in this array that is there anything with id of this id. So if it is there, then it is going to return that particular friend. If it is not, then empty. So now inside our the circle thing, we can give a if condition. So if check user, so that's all enough for the if condition, and down we will give a else condition. Yeah, I forgot the v. Now it's okay. Now wait till it compiles and just go and reload, and now I think we have done some errors, I think. Yeah, we're done. Yeah, I think there is no need of this ID. So now reload. Yeah, now it's showing green because I have changed the pattern. So red should be down here and the green should be above. And now if I reload, you can see that all the users are indicating as red since no one is online. So I will give you a demonstration by logging in as any one of the user. So and before doing that, our alignment of this red dot is not good, so it's not going to the right side. So for that, just go to our chat index.php, and inside this anchor tag we are going to style it with justify content and space between. So this is a flex command. Now you can see that it's moving to the right side of the column. So I have done forgot to mention one thing, that inside our online user.view file, inside the props, we are having the online users here, and we have the US capital just into small letter, and also inside the index.blade.php just change the U to small letters. And I am doing like this, don't do out here, it's because it's getting from the app.js file, and it's a variable, not just anything, just we have created right now. And since so why I have told to change the capital U to small U is that the HTML is capital sensitive, and if we have defined it as capital, then we have to give a hyphen out here and out here too. Yeah, also don't forget to change out here. Yeah, and inside our index.blade.php we are defining, or we are binding it as friends. We are having an S out here, so just remove it. So I'm extremely sorry for the mistake that I have done and making it to change it in the last moment. So I have one more last thing to show you. So inside our check user function, inside here we are checking the we are giving the ID as the whole friend. Instead we need to define the ID itself. So last time we got an error because this friend was not defined here. So now I have opened up two browsers simultaneously. So if I click this login button right here, then you can see that Arun Ferry's red icon will be changed into a green one. So I have clicked the login button. So it is having a 2 seconds or 1 second lag, but it surely does change without a reload. So if I go log out, then it will be changed into a red icon. So that's all for today's video, guys. If you want more videos like this, don't forget to click the subscribe button down below, and don't forget to click the notification bell icon. And you can always give me feedback, and if you have any doubts, you can just comment it below or contact me through Gmail or Facebook. So thanks for watching, guys.